screen, is that we have a God. We have a God that is perfectly represented in Jesus, who is raising up a Jesus-looking people, transforming the world in a Jesus-looking way. And that's you and me. That's his church. We are the church, individuals. It's not a building. It's each one of us. And so we are a Jesus-looking people, transforming the world in a Jesus-looking way. There is no other way except the way that Christ demonstrated that as he walked on the face of this earth. It's all laid out in the Gospels for us there. And then Paul continues that journey. Through the book of Acts, we see that journey continued in the early church, manifesting Christ-like, cross-like, redemptive, sacrificial love wherever they went. And that's what we carry. And all with one thing in mind from the Father's heart: people being reconciled back to the Father. Relationship restored to our Father, to our God, so that we are truly, we know that we are truly sons and daughters of the living God. And there's no doubt about that in any one of our minds, that we've just got it and we're walking in that, seeking to do what our Father's will. Father, your will be done, not mine. Getting about our Father's business, because we carry his nature, we carry his heart. But as I said last week, that's half the gospel. The other half is that we're to be reconciled to one another. The John 17 passage, you need to grab a hold of last week's message. It's online on YouTube. You can watch it. I suggest you watch it several times. That we are in, from Jesus' heart and the Father's heart, he's looking for a people who are not only reconciled to him, but are reconciled to each other, and to carry a message of reconciliation, which is a message of relational wholeness. That we can be relationally whole, not just with him, but together in the power of his love. This is the crux of it all. And as believers, as we're carrying that message of Christ, that carrying that message of the cross, we're carrying this gospel message, we're becoming a people who imitate him. And as Paul said, imitate me as I imitate Christ. So we're carrying it in such a way, and it's so attractive that as people see this message, they begin to imitate that love and that lifestyle and that relational wholeness, because they see it in every one of us. And so the reason we got here in the first place is my heart just really being moved by what I'm seeing happening in the world around us. These incredible polarizing voices everywhere, in the media, in social media, wherever you look, in politics, both sides of politics. I don't care which side of politics you vote for, both sides, there's this us and them thing happening, polarization. And I've just been shifted from incredible sadness in that to anger in watching what's happening. People just building bigger walls. The divide has been growing, and that is the work of the enemy. The message of Christ and the message of the cross and the message of the gospel is a message of reconciliation. The message of the enemy is a message of polarization. Did you get that? Reconciliation is kingdom. Polarization is the work of the enemy. And the whole world is under the sway of the enemy. All systems of the world, all governmental systems of the world, good or bad. I thank God we live in Australia, in this democratic country where we have a right to vote and a right to have a say, and have got some decent government. But all the systems of the world, the Bible tells me, are under the influence of the schemer, the accuser, and the enemy. We're kingdom. We sit and stand in the kingdom. We're sons and daughters of the living God. We have a whole new government and a whole new way. And so this polarization thing has been rising up. And I get angry because I see it in the church partnering with that spirit that just wants to point the finger and judge and accuse and build bigger walls rather than tear down walls, which is the message of the gospel. Jesus came to tear down every wall, every racist wall, every wall of hatred, every wall of division, every wall of separation, that we would be one. This is the message of Christ, and it's the message of gospel. And he did it not by taking up a sword, but by dying on a cross as an example for all of us to follow and for all the world to see. It's his love. So I've been watching all that.